battle me, who can stand against us? When we call on his great name, Jesus, 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 we have the victory. Oh, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Satan will have to flee. Oh, tell me, who can stand against us when we call on his great name? Jesus, 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 we have the victory. Come on, stand on your feet. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory. You gotta believe it. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Satan will have to flee. Oh, tell me, who can stand against us when we call on his great name? Jesus, 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 we have the victory. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory. We gotta know it, y'all. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Satan will have to flee. Oh, tell me, who can stand against us when we call on his great name? Jesus, 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 we have the victory. Come on, let's sing it this time with victory. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Satan will have to flee. Oh, tell me, who can stand against us? Will we call on his great name? Jesus, 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 we have the victory. Hallelujah. Clap your hands if you have the victory in Jesus' name. Clap your hands if you got the victory in Jesus' name. Clap your hands if you got the victory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Everybody please stand. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, he's worthy. Yes, he's worthy. Although we may not be worthy, he is worthy. Hallelujah. We got to shake this off, saints. We got to get right. We are complete. Even to my own fault, to my own shame. We are complete. There's no excuse we should be coming up short as saints. No excuse. How are we going to be a standard, a banner for the world to see? And we got Christ on the inside and we're falling short. Hallelujah. So we got to shake it off, saints, because it's not like we don't know better. We know better. Amen? All of us. And that's for the, all of Church Apostolicity, because this is a remnant church. Yes. Amen? Yes. Our heads bowed. Lord, Father God, in the presence of the name of Jesus, Lord God, we just say thank you. Lord God, you're so worthy. You're so merciful, yes, Lord God. You're so graceful, Lord God. Thank you for your continuous preaching, Lord God. We want to know where we're falling short, Lord God. Even though we know, Lord God, we are not worthy, Lord God. And we need to fix it, Lord God. So fix us this day, Lord God. Whatever you got to do, Lord God, do it. Oh, hallelujah. We say thank you for your messenger, for our pastor, Lord God. Thank you for someone to be continuously on their job, Lord God, that we may one day, Lord Father God, be able to be pleasing in your sight, Lord God. We say thank you this day, Lord God. Oh, Lord, let us praise you this day like no other, Lord God, that you get all the glory, all the praise, all the honor, Lord God, because you dig around us, Lord God. You wink at sins, Lord God. You deal with so much, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. But we are going to strive to make it, Lord God. Thank you for just being mindful of us, Lord God. And we know, Lord God, that we take for granted your grace, Lord God. But thank you. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, Lord, we just want to make sure for today, Lord God, that we do what's right. Oh, and you worry about tomorrow. But today, Lord God, we want to get right in your sight, Lord God. And it's all possible in Jesus' name. That's who we trust in, Lord. So we say thank you, Lord God. In your precious and holy name, Lord God, we ask you many blessings to come forth. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. While you're standing, please open your Bibles. Amen. To Ephesians chapter 6. We're going to read verses 12 and 13. When there, please say amen. Ephesians chapter 6, verses 12 and 13. Word of God reads, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickednesses in high places. Therefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and have it done all to stand." Amen? Amen, amen. And right now we're going to have our, amen, praise choir, amen?
Every praise is to our God, every word of worship with one accord. Every praise is to our God. Every praise is to our God, every word of worship with one accord. Every praise is to our God. Hallelujah to our God. Glory, hallelujah, is to our God. Every praise is to our God. Every praise is to our God. Every word of worship with one accord. God, my healer.
Don't give up. We have come to give you praise, Holy One and Jehovah. We have come in victory, your will and liberty. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah to the King.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to the King.
Oh, we have come to give you praise, Holy One, and Jehovah. We have come in victory, here we alone, and liberty. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to the King.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah to the King.
Oh, we have come to give you praise. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah to the King.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
salvation and glory. Hallelujah. He's wonderful. Hallelujah. God is good. I love being saved. There's nothing like being saved. Hallelujah. Come on, shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Salvation and glory. God is so good to me. God is so good to me. All right, tithes and offering. Amen. Time to give unto the Lord. Time to give unto the Lord. Amen. It's time to give unto the Lord. You know, one of the things about giving. Oh, here, Papa David. Amen. All of y'all that have these cordless mics, when y'all finish singing from now on, y'all grab your mic and drop it here on your way to your seat. Amen. And the rest of y'all still do the norm. I'm going to make some changes. I'm going to make things work a little smoother for us around here. But anyway, the one thing about offering, I do not hound you all about giving nothing extra. Y'all stop talking. I want everybody to hear me. I don't hound you all about giving nothing extra. You know, we've talked about your tithes. We've talked about offering. We've talked about the different other funds, whatever they may be. You know, if y'all was to go to another church, they have y'all giving the pastor shine shoes fund, gas funds, and all of that. And sometimes, listen, sometimes you all are just too cheap. Let me say it over by me. Sometimes they just too cheap. Amen. Amen. All y'all give is just your tithes and offering. You keep it right at the door. Come on. You won't do nothing extra. That's why your blessings are so limited.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. I don't put a lot of pressure on you, and I'm never going to do that. But at some point, y'all got to grow up and know, I'm going to give God some more since he keep blessing me. Amen. Y'all been sitting around me for years, and I'm not going to start. Amen. I'm just putting it on your mind.
Yes.
Sometimes go over your tithes and offering. Sometimes say, I'm going to give an extra 50 today, or extra 20, extra 10, extra 5, extra dollar. Give something extra sometime. Stop just sticking to the norm. Stop just doing exactly what God wants. That's why you never prosper. And I ain't talking about money. You won't even prosper in your life, because if you can't give up your money, you won't give up your time. That's Bible. You don't give up your money, you won't give up your time. So sometimes you all have extra money. Y'all done paid all of your bills, and you got an extra $100, $150. And I'm not saying you got to give God all of it. You ain't got to give him none of it. But you take, oh, I got an extra $100. I'm going to buy me a new what? You already got 10 of them you ain't using. Why you going to go buy another one? Amen. Let's learn to be cheerful givers. That's all I'm saying. Be a cheerful giver. Say, you know, I got some extra money today. Let me give God an extra. You put the number on it. I really don't care. I'm just letting you know, God says sometimes y'all just need to give something extra. Stop just sticking to the straight norm all the time. Amen?
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen?
Can I get an amen?
Amen?
Can I get an amen?
Amen?
All right. Let us stand. You're now in the hands of our ushers and choir. Amen.
To be praised.
magnify the Lord, for He is worthy to be praised. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock of my salvation. Oh, magnify the Lord, for He is worthy to be praised. Oh, magnify the Lord, for He is worthy to be praised. Jesus is the rock, Jesus is the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, Jesus is the rock, Jesus is the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, Jesus is the rock, Jesus is the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, Jesus is the rock, Jesus is the rock of my salvation. Oh, magnify the Lord, for He is worthy to be praised. Oh, magnify the Lord, for He is worthy to be praised. Hosanna, Jesus is the rock, Jesus is the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, Jesus is the rock,
Jesus is the rock of my salvation. Come on, the church shout hallelujah. Let the church shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Time for the word of God. Amen. Yeah. Time for the word of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. God is good. Yes, He is. Is He really good, Brother Tommy?
He's better than that.
Better than that. Hot dog it. Who all of him love being saved? That wasn't a lot of hallelujah, but praise the Lord anyway. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Let's go to Luke chapter 13. You know, one thing about correction is that you got to learn to take correction and don't get an attitude after you take it. You take it in the chest, know I messed up, I'm fixing it. Leave it right there. Don't take it any further. Be a man. When I say about be a man, I ain't saying don't be a woman or nothing. I'm saying take it in the chest. Bow your back and take it. Okay, I messed up. I ain't going to do that no more. I ain't gonna do you crying over spilled milk. It's gone. It's gone. You can't get it back. Amen. Just know the reason I'm not going to mess up again, because I didn't like that slap I got yesterday. And I don't want to get slapped no more. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I don't like getting in trouble with God. Hallelujah. I don't like getting in trouble with God, man. God know how to hit you and never lay a hand on you. But you've been hit. So I ain't getting hit no more. Amen. Amen. And we have to learn that You know, just take correction and be through with it. I'm not saying take it, ignore it, and don't do nothing with it. That's not. But I'm saying learn how to take it and don't let it interfere with the next 10 minutes of your life. You know, don't let it keep interfering with your life for days and weeks. Just take it, go home, say to yourself, I ain't going to do that no more. Amen. Amen. Because it's going to hurt. And if you tell yourself, I'm not going to do it no more, you're going to remember it. Because I ain't doing that no more. I know what I did last time. Amen. What that got to do with the sermon today? The true source of sin and righteousness is in your heart. The true source of sin or the true source of righteousness is in your heart. That's where it all come from. Amen. I'm still not sure of the title of the message because God got two subjects he's going to hook together somehow. And I don't know how he's going to do it yet, but he's going to hook it together talking about your heart and letting you know only a few people going to make it. Only a few. A few is one out of every three. That's why I tell y'all don't want to be in my three. If you're in my three, you're going to hell because I'm going to heaven. Nobody going to replace me. Amen. I've worked too hard and worked too long. No. Amen. But the true source of who you are comes out of your heart. Amen. Luke chapter 13, verse 22. Thank you, Jesus. It may appear a little confusing, but y'all stick with me. And somehow God gonna make this make sense with these verses that we are going to use today. Amen. But I want you to put in your head to start off with the true source of sin or the true source of righteousness comes from your heart. Comes from your heart. That's what dictates what you are or how you live or how you perform. Amen. Verse 22, let's read. What does it say? And he went through the cities and villages, teaching and journeying toward Jerusalem. Then said one unto him, Lord, are there few that be saved? He said, now why? Because remember, they walking with Jesus. And obviously they saw some, heard some, perceived some, comprehended something to make them, Lord, ain't but a few people going to make it? They talking to God. They talking to Jesus. And they ask him the question, you mean to tell me only a few people going to make it? And Jesus, look how Jesus responded to him. Strive to what? To enter in at the straight gate. That straight gate. For all of you all that don't know, straight means it's a difficult gate to go through. It's not an easy, that's not straight as in a straight line. The word is spelled different. This straight meaning when you walk up to this door, I'm going to open the door for you. And when you look through, you don't even see a pathway. But that's the door you got to go through if you want to get to heaven. You like, how am I going to get through that? You know, read it again. Strive. Now, he's telling you when you walk up to the door and I open it for you, you're going to see it's really no pathway. You see a little line that you can maneuver through, you know, and get through there. But you're saying, well, I got to go through that. He said, strive. That means work hard as you can to get through there, because it ain't easy to walk through. It's not easy. And all you see is obstacle. First obstacle you see when a person come to church and want to be church, come to church and live in church or do right, the first thing a human see, I got to give my money to that man. My hard-earned dollar, I got to give him a portion of it, faithfully. I ain't giving my money. So, you don't strive, so you stick a foot in the door. Now, the next obstacle come in is that I can't be who I am no more. You're like, wait a minute. I got to give up my money and I can't be who I am no more? That's a hard thing to do, isn't it? What did I tell you about being honest? Everybody ought to shout it, amen.
Y'all know good and well, y'all don't like me telling you what to do, and you don't like giving me your money. You have to learn it like that. But that was the first thing you said or say when people come in. Listen, that man, he don't need my money. Look what he got on. Maybe I don't, maybe I do, but that's got nothing to do with your salvation. Your salvation is you better strive to come through that door. You better put forth a lot of effort, because the first thing you got to do is support the church that you want to come to. This is your church. You can't expect me to work a job, preach and teach and do all of this, and then you can't give me money. Now, I can show you scripture. Don't muzzle the ox that traded out the corn. Amen. The tithes and offering belong to the priests. Amen. I can get every dime if I want to. That's Bible. Amen. But God, no, I'm not going to do that. But you got to strive. So now you got to strive to go through a complicated door. Remember, the question is, ain't but a few people going to make it? Because ain't but a few people going to do that. Oh, hallelujah. Now, not only do I have to give up my money, not only do I have to be who I am, I got to love folk that I hate. They done mistreated me all their life. I ain't got nothing to do. No, you can't do that no more. Wait a minute. You ain't even got in the door yet. You stuck a foot in and pulled it back out, but you still looking at the door. You mean to tell me I got to do all? I don't think all of that is necessary. So you go find another door. And you walk through this door quick. Wait a minute. You just fell out of the few. Because he just told you this is not an easy thing to do. Strive to enter in at the straight gate. Watch this. For many, I say unto you, will many going to walk up to the door. Many of them going to get the door open, but only a few of them going to walk through it. Right. Oh, hallelujah. Many going to come to the door. I want to be saved. I want to join that church. I want to live holy. I want to love the Lord, but I ain't giving up my money. You want 10% of everything I get off the top. Then you want me to give you an offering. Then you want me to love folk that I hate, that hate me, that mistreated me all my life, that abused me three ways, sides, and flat, and you telling me I got to love? No, not that scoundrel. They too trifling. I ain't loving them. And then you say, I can't be who I am. Well, I've been like this all my life. Now, that's just three things that's going to shake and rattle you that you don't want to let go. But remember, all you're doing is standing at the door right now. You haven't even, but you found a bigger door with no complication. You can give. Well, y'all can come and give like you want to. You can give like you want to at this church. Amen. Now, you're going to do it, but no, there's rules set for you to follow. I'm not going to get into that today. Amen. Strive to enter into the straight gate. For many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in. They ain't able. They ain't able. How are they not able? Is it because they don't have the physical ability to do it? Or they choose not to do it? Because you can walk through a door. You can walk in a gang infested area and get shot if you want to. You can walk into a strip club if you want to. You can walk into selling dope if you want to. You can walk into getting high if you want to. You can walk anywhere you want to walk. But if you decide if you want to walk in that door or not. Amen. Then, see, some of us, I'll talk about this a little later today, maybe tonight. Some of y'all done got in there and you be like, I'm turning around. This, I can't do this. This is just too much. Amen. Yeah. Come on. What verse was that? 24? Now go to Matthew chapter 7. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Still don't have a topic for you today yet. But God going to give us one for it's all said and done. Chapter 7. We're going to go to verse 13. The source of your sin and righteousness is in your heart. That's where it is. Whatever you do, that's where it gets mixed up and made up, and it just comes out. Amen. Hallelujah. Y'all got it? Chapter 7 of the book of Matthew, verse 13. Read. What does it say? Enter ye in the what gate? For wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. Wide is the gate, broad is the way But you going to hell if you go through that gate. He letting you know, ain't but two gates. God, and God is so wonderful, he opened the doors of both of them. I like to think he got the straight gate door open over here and the wide door open over here. And you standing there, you look in this one. I ain't going in there. You look in this one, everybody having a party. I'm going in that gate. He said, but I'm telling you where it's leading you to. Now you're going to hell if you go through that gate. But you, it's your call. Make your choice and live with it. If you go through the straight gate, you're gonna hustle all the way to heaven. You go through the wide gate, you're going to have a smooth sailing. Hallelujah. But he said many, 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 many. That's why you got more people in phony churches than good, strict churches. If your church ain't strict, you in the wrong door. You done went through the wrong aisle. This is a strict way of life over here. This is not a life. But here's the wonderful part about the strictness of the life. The more you live it, the easier it becomes. It's peace to love your enemy. Y'all ever dislike somebody, Mother Johnson? You dodging them all the time. They coming that way. Listen, look how you messing up your day because you don't want to pass by somebody. But imagine when you can pass by everybody, shake everybody's hand. Amen. People tell me, I hate homosexuals. I don't hate homosexuals. I hate what they do. I hate what a liar do. I hate when y'all don't come to church like you're supposed to. I don't hate no humans. I hate what y'all choose to do by disobeying the word of God. That's what I hate. And that, if you do anything, I hate Joseph. He don't come home like I tell him. Well, I hate what he does, brother. You know what I'm saying? They say, I don't hate you, son. You know that. You keep me broke. How can I hate you? Amen. But I don't like what he does when he break my rule. I'm going to say something. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Next verse. Look what he said. Hallelujah. I love this. And I ain't even got started yet. Come on. Verse 14 said what? Because. Come on. Because. Straight is the gate. And what? Narrow is the way. Where does it lead to? What? No. Where does it lead to? Where is life at? Who want life? Come on, wave your hand. You want life. All right? Then you in the right church, but don't leave it. This is strict over here. Because when it gets easy, I done gone off my rock. Go find another one. Get away from me. When I make being a member of Church of Apostolicity easy, when I let you sin and don't say nothing, when I let you live a raggedy life and I don't say nothing, when I don't embarrass you occasionally, then you might want to go find you another church. Amen. Because this is straight and it's narrow, but it leadeth unto life. Amen. But look at the last statement. And few. Oh, wait a minute. Find it. I thought it was readily open there. I like it when people come here and they come to the church and they come in and they say, man, you would never think you got all of this on the outside because you're looking at the wrong thing. You're looking at the appearance. Look at the heart. Come inside and see the heart of Church of Apostolate. Come inside and see the people in Church of Apostolate. Come inside and see what's on the other side of that door. Stop worrying about what the door look like. Amen. And worry about what's on the other side of that door. What am I saying? Hallelujah. What did I tell you? The source of sin, and in this case, righteousness, comes from the heart. You want to really know what we're about, you come in here and listen to me. Hallelujah. You ain't got to let nobody tell you about me. Come in here and listen to me. Come in and see the heart of the matter. Come and see what's really going on the other side. Told y'all don't really notice. Y'all haven't noticed. There's no sign saying what's the name of this church out there. There's no sign out there say this is Church of Apostolicity. No sign that say church. Listen, what am I saying? It's just a church. But, oh, thank you, Jesus. But when you come in here, you got people in here that love you. You got people in here that's kind. You got people in here that's polite. You got people in here that's going to tell you how to live. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, read it again. Verse 14. Read. We in Matthew chapter 7, verse 14. What did he say? Because what? And what? Which leadeth? And few there be that? Few. One in every three. Wait a minute. Got to find it. Wait a minute. One in every three got to find it. Hold on a second. I love being saved, man. Ain't nothing like it. I don't know what y'all looking for. I don't know. Some of y'all ain't really looking to be saved. Y'all know that? Okay. Now Luke said, I say unto you, we'll seek to any end and not be able. That means they found it. Come here, Joseph and Jason. Come here, get up. Y'all sitting up front. Boy, y'all ain't gonna sleep today. I'm gonna use y'all for my scenario. Now watch this. Now watch this. Now Luke said, few there be that find it. Right? Now, you came with three, you and two others came, they went back, you stayed. You came with two others, they went back, because you were the few in that group and y'all found it. I had two others and they went back and I stayed. Now, all three of us was in the few group, wasn't we? But what did Matthew just say? Only few gonna be able to go in. Now, they made it to the door and they looked at it and they locked the door. Right? I did too. But ain't but one of us going in that door. Y'all don't stay there. Y'all don't get what I'm saying. They hustled to find Church of Apostolicity and they love it. He hustled and he loved it. I hustled and I love it. But even after we hustled and love it, still only one of us gonna make it. That's why y'all don't want to be in my three. You going to hell if you're in my three. Because I'm going. Ain't nobody going to replace me. Hallelujah. Y'all can take your seat. But I'm showing you how strict this thing is. So you get a bunch of people that come to church and you think all of them going. No, it ain't. Beverly, you live a darn good pretty life. You, Sabrina. But y'all mixed in with my three. Y'all mixed in with my three. That's dangerous. Oh, hallelujah. Because I am not going to be replaced. Oh, y'all better find you another three group to get in. Because look, didn't he say, watch this. He said, only few be able to find it. Listen, but all of us show up. But ain't but three, ain't but one going in. Ain't but one of us going through that door. Wait a minute. And all three of us know it's strict. We all three repaired our tithe. We coming to church. We praying. We fasting. But God said, but ain't but one of y'all gonna make it. What am I saying? The source of your sin or the source of your righteousness coming from your heart. So you can look like you're doing good. See? And that's where the tricky part come in. Because y'all will say, all three of us look like we're doing good, don't we? But only God knows which one is doing it from the heart. Oh, hallelujah. See, that's where it boils down to now. God say, I'm watching your works. Because we can fake. Human, we can fake. We can fake folks out. Easy game. Amen, lights. Y'all know good and well y'all can fake folks out when y'all want to. Hallelujah. I ain't going to even talk about some of you husband and wives. Y'all got faith, didn't you? Luke chapter 6. Come on. Hallelujah. Y'all got faith. Sister Porter didn't fake me. I didn't fake you either. Come on. Luke chapter 6. Hallelujah. I want y'all to get this today. Remember, the source. The source of your sin or your righteousness comes from your heart. Now, only a few gonna make it. One in every three. Put that in your head. Amen. And then on top of that, he said, I'm watching your works. Now, we gonna call it fruit for today. Come on. Chapter 6, verse 31. You got it? Verse 31. You got it? Let's read. Luke. And as ye would men do to you, do ye. Watch this. Watch this. Beverly, you love your family. Huh? Right? And you one of my three. Right? You love your family. Read the first verse. The next verse. What does it say? For if ye love Sinners do that. Sinners do that. So we both show we love, right? Sinners do what he doing. Sabrina, you love your family, don't you? You got a whole bunch of them. You love them all. He said, that ain't no good. Sinners do that. Talking about you want to go through this straight and narrow. He said, do that. Impress me. Because what you loving folk, loving your mama, he said, I don't mean nothing to me. Sinners do that. You love your spouse, your children, your uncle, your cousin, your sister, your brother. What's the next verse he said? Verse 3 said what? He said, and if ye, come on, y'all read. Y'all got to read. Come on, verse 33 said what? What have ye? Sinners do that. Talking about going through this straight and narrow. But we all three of us look good. But all three of us doing what sinners do. So God say, you ain't impressing me. Cause y'all take care of your mama when she's sick. God say, sinners do that. God said, that ain't impressive to me. God say, y'all do good. Y'all loan people money that loan y'all money. God said, sinners do that. He said, that ain't impressing me. You're doing good. You're doing good to who do good to you. God said, that is not impressive to me. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Next verse, he said, what? What verse y'all at? 34. He said, what? And if ye lend. Wait a minute. You loan. I'm going to loan Tim some money. Oh, Tim going to get my money back. He sinners do that. Oh, Beverly, can I borrow $100? Yeah, Pastor, because I'm going to get it back. Sinners do that. See what we, see, so, remember I said some of us done walked through the door, but we ain't went no further yet. We doing inside the door what sinners do. Because watch this. The funny part about it, the same thing you have to do in the straight door, you have to do it in the wide door. Here's the difference. You deal with it differently, though. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I feel good. You deal with it different. So you got to take care of people as a sinner and as a saint. But God say, impress me. Come on, read. 34 from the top, read. He said, and if ye lend to them whom ye hope to receive, what think have ye? For sinners also lend to sinners. Bank of America, loan you some money. Long as you give them interest back. You go buy a $350,000 house, and if you finance it at a certain rate and keep it for 30 years, you pay $700,000 for that house. And Bank of America, good. Oh, he's a good boy. Loan him some money to get a car. Sinners, we take care. But look at the next verse. Now you want to impress God. See, y'all don't impress me. But don't remember I told y'all when I was a supervisor on a job, I did not promote you or give you a raise because you did what I hired you to do. Well, I come to work on time. Ain't that the law? Missing work and you get fired. Well, I'm always here doing my job. I thought that's what we agreed to. Impress me if you want something extra. God said, y'all want something extra from me? Impress me. Come on, read. What's the next verse? He said, what? But ye love. And do good and lean, hoping. And your reward. So if I want to borrow it, so somebody want, who in here don't pay folk back? Don't y'all answer that question. But y'all know we got folks here won't pay you back. Keep giving them money when they ask you though. God said, now you impress me. Oh, hallelujah. But y'all don't want to do that. Y'all want to give to somebody that's going to give it back. God said, sinners do that. I thought you said you were saved. If you're going to be saved and you're going through this straight door, I expect something extra out of you. I expect you to give and don't want it back. If you get it back, if the person give it back, if you want it back, when they offer, take it. If you don't have to take it. God say, that's the kind of person I want to see. Hallelujah. He said, whatever, your reward shall be great and ye shall be called the children of the highest. For he is kind unto the and to the. Come on, jump down to verse 41. What does it say? And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but perceivest not the. Why are you looking down on somebody and you think you ain't got no problem? Let's make it easy for us. God give us stuff all the time. Who's really giving God something? Who? Watch this. I know y'all say, well, I go to church to get my tithes and offering. He sinners do that. Sinners do that. Impress me. Sinners do what you're doing. Amen. A person that's just a church member will come to church and give tithes and offering, won't join no auxiliary, won't do nothing. And then you think because you join one auxiliary, because you work in the kitchen. I do something at the church. I work in the kitchen. Okay, God said, okay. Impress me. Let me see you do something outside of the norm. Number one, God said, the number one thing I want to see you do is be punctual when you're supposed to be somewhere. He said, how many of y'all give me that? Well, I did it today. Today, one time ain't enough. That's lukewarm. I want it all the time. Be punctual all the time. Do that for me. The military don't even play around with that. You 15 minutes early, you 30 minutes late. See, y'all need to join the military. Hey, man, Sarge, you late. Well, I'm early. It's 15 minutes. He said, who told you that? Well, what were you trained at? That ain't the training we put in you. Oh, hallelujah. God said, I didn't put that kind of training in you. The training I put in you is that when I speak, you jump. When I woke you up, that means I wanted you to get busy and get somewhere. Not for you to lay in the bed. Not for you to go sit down and eat breakfast. Not for you to make sure you get there right on time. Come on, read. What verse was that? 35, I want to go. 41, 42 say what? Stop looking at your brother and finding fault with them like you perfect. Like you ain't got nothing going wrong in your life. Where you get that dumb stuff from? All of this stuff. How many times you don't thank God for what he's given you? How many times you don't impress God? How many times you disobey him? Come on, read 42. How canst thou say to thy brother, let me pull out the mote that is in thine eye, when thou thyself beholdest not the beam that is in thy own eye? Thou hypocrite, cast out first the beam that of thy own, and then you will know how to pull out. When you learn to live right, then you can help somebody out. You know, the only way, I won't say the best, because ain't but one way to help somebody. Ain't but one way to help a person. It's go with them. I tell a married couple, when somebody commit adultery, when one commit adultery, I say, the only way to help that person, if they willing to stay with you, because you what you did, you threw them in a hole. In the hole, there's no way to climb out. The walls are slick. There's no rocks. You can't grab nothing because they're hurting. And they hurting some awful. They hurting. Especially when they know they love you and they've never been unfaithful. They are burning up with hurt. They dealing with demons they never had to deal with before. Because now they don't trust nothing you say. So what you did, you threw them in a deep hole. But here's the problem. They can't climb out. Because they ain't never been hurt like this before. They don't know how to believe you or not believe you. Because they believed you and found out 20 of them lies you told a day, 20 of them stories you told a day was lies. Now I don't know what to do. I'm in torment. I can't think straight. So when you say you at Starbucks, well, you told me when you used to be, tell me that you was meeting that person. Now you're telling me you at Starbucks again. And I'm supposed to believe you. It don't work like that. So you got them in a hole. And you can't throw down in a rope and pull them out. Because, baby, I'm sorry, don't work no more. Baby, I made a mistake, does not work. Are y'all keeping up with me? That doesn't work no more. The only way to get that person out the hole, you got to jump in there with them and y'all going to climb out together. That means the pain that person is going through, you got to be there to feel it every time. But wait a minute, you don't know how to feel another person's pain. What am I saying? You want to help somebody that's down and out? You want to help somebody that's a thief? You want to help somebody that's a crook? You got to get close to them. Come here. Told you I'm going to use y'all. Listen, you got to get close to this brother. The only way you're going to help this brother, you got to hook up with him and say, man, come on, let's go have lunch together. Come on, tell me what's wrong. Instead of saying, why are you always drunk? The boy's drunk for a reason. You think he like getting drunk? He liked getting drunk because he's, oh, hallelujah. Go sit down. He's struggling through something. So why don't you hang out with him for a minute sometime when you can? And then you will find out he's not what you thought he was because you don't know what he's been through to be the, oh, hallelujah. But we quick to say, oh, look at him. They just a drunk. You don't know what that boy been through. But look at your own self. Don't you remember your drunk days? Why did you get drunk, Beverly? You was dealing with stuff. But Jesus came along and hooked up with you and said, come on, boy. Come on. I'm there with you. I can go wherever you want to go. Just talk to me. Tell me what's wrong. I'm here to encourage you. I'm here to strengthen you. I ain't going to find fault with you because I know you're jacked up. You're jacked up because you don't know me. Listen, a person is messed up because they don't know Jesus. That's why they messed up. They don't know him. They know of him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Come on, verse 43. Do I want that one? Yeah. Read. For this is the part we're getting to now. Watch this. He said what? Bring it not forth corrupt fruit. If you really love a person, remember, y'all my three. Y'all my two. We're in a group together. Are you encouraging people every day, all the time? Are you encouraging people every day? Because I am. Amen. I'm going after the one that need help, and I ain't criticizing them. I'm going after them. I may fuss at them with them, but I'm still going out. Are you doing that? Are you doing that? Remember, we both done went through the door. We both inside that straight gate, but now we got to perform some duties while we're in there. Hallelujah. Now, God is saying out of us three, but one of us going to make it. Now, we ain't striving against each other. We're striving against our own self. But God is saying, it's so many people. Listen, somebody say, well, Pastor, how you come up with that? He said, there's going to be a great falling away. That means a bunch of folks was doing right, but somebody turned around and went back the other way. Maybe they didn't turn around physically, but they turned around in their heart. Come on, read. Come on, what verse we at? Thank you, Jesus. 40 what? Read. He said, well, for every tree is known. That's $1 million statement there. Read it again. He said, what? For every tree is known by his. Known by his. We all at Church of Apostles. Listen to you, huh? Church of Apostolicity get fruit from all three of us. But God said, I'm looking at you individual fruit. So when God look at our individual fruit, what is he seeing? Because all three of us will show up for witnessing. But how many of us showed up for witnesses complaining? How many of us doing it to be seen? How many waiting for the pastor to leave so they can bounce? Oh, I got a meeting today with Bishop Douglas, y'all, so I got to go. All right, Pastor, we love you. See you later. Soon as I turn the corner, here come Beverly saying, James, you know, I promised my wife. You know, so I got to go. And here comes Sabrina. Well, you know, I made a hair appointment 2 weeks ago, and I got to keep it. But I made a witnessing appointment for every second Saturday of the month a year ago. So why did you put that on the day you know wasn't available? Or why couldn't you make it later? See, God is looking at your heart, but you think, because you made a good showing, he said, you made a good showing. Sinners do that. Sinners do that. Oh, hallelujah. Hope y'all with me. You're known by your fruit. See, y'all want to worry about what people think about you. Look at yourself. What kind of fruit are you producing? Because that's what God is looking at. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. What verse we at now? Do we read all of 44? Read. He said what? For every tree is known by his own fruit. For of thorns men do not gather fig, nor a bush gather they grapes. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is good, and an evil man out of the evil treasures of his heart bringeth that which is evil. Wait a minute. So I told you at the very beginning, the source of your sin is from your heart. Or the source of your righteousness is from your heart. He said you do what you do because it's in your heart. But see, y'all think, like, been here, what, 14 years. had the name on the church once, the little sign. The wind blew it. I ain't bothered to put it back. You drive by, there's no name on the church. But you drive by and you hear people say all the time, man, they show a lot of kids that they show be at church a lot. You know, I know y'all talk to people because people talk to me. They say, what guy am I going back? And I, you know, you be out and you say, what they say, what church you go to? And I tell them, they say, that church on 54? That one that got all them signs up there in the church and be honest, yeah. He said, man, I always say I'm going to stop by there one day. Why you want to stop by? Because you see some of the evidence of what's going on. But when you look at the building, technically, you really don't know it's a church. There's no name up there. Somebody said, when you going to put a name? I said, well, I've come 14 years. I don't know if I want a name up there now. I keep thinking about it. And every time I ask the brother to do it, I change my mind. Because I ain't sure. Do I need a name? That's $1 million question. Now, do I need a name? It's working without one, ain't it? Because it ain't about the name. Talking about your name or church name. It's about what you're doing on the inside. Oh, hallelujah. Listen, Jesus, there's no other name. Listen, the only name that matters is Jesus. Y'all ain't even say it. The only name that matters is
Jesus.
What name can heal you?
Jesus.
What name can strengthen you?
Jesus.
What name can restore you?
Jesus.
What name can build you up? What name can save your soul? That's the only name that matters. Oh, hallelujah. But we worry about all these other names. Listen, my name can't do nothing for you. John Fulton Porter. Okay. Go pray in John Fulton Porter and see what happened. Not a darn thing. Amen. Come on. Come on. Verse 45, the very end. What did it say? For out of thee, what you say is because you're full of it. What you talk about all the time is because you're full of it. So all y'all that like to talk about sports, you're full of it. All y'all like to talk about clothes and new garments, brand names, you're full of it. All of us like to talk about Jesus. Let me go back over here with my three. What you like talking about? We don't want to put you on the spot, Brother Beverly. What you like talking about? Don't answer that. Now, y'all know what I like talking about. Somebody, y'all tell me, y'all, Pastor, you always got to go religious. I'm full of it. Can't talk about nothing there. I can hold a 15-second conversation. Please don't talk to me about no sports. I don't know nothing. I'm going to look at you and go, yeah. You're not a person fake like they interested because I don't want to offend you. I ain't interested in no sports. I ain't interested in no clothes. I ain't interested in the weather. I'm not interested in the news. I'm not interested in black folks getting killed. I'm not interested in white folks getting killed. I'm interested in souls going to hell. I don't care what color you are. You got a soul. That's what I'm interested in. I ain't trying to save the black folk. I ain't trying to save the white folk. I'm trying to save lost folks. Oh, y'all see, y'all miss all of that. I'm trying to save folk that need help and want Jesus. I'm not trying to save hypocrites. I'm not trying to save saints that acting like sinners. I want folk with you. Now, somebody say, well, you're showing favoritism. Well, I think I'm in good company. Jesus said, I came not to call the righteous. I came to seek that which is they that I hold need not a. I want the sick. I want the lame. I want the one that's struggling and don't know what to do or which way to go. And I'm going to tell them, come on, man, through this hard door. It's hard, but just hold on to my coattail because I'm holding on to Jesus' coattail. And when he move, I move. Hey, if I don't move, don't you move. Listen, that's why when y'all ask me, Pastor, can we do something? I say, I'm praying about it. Pastor, it's almost time. Well, Jesus ain't gave me nothing, so in my mind, it ain't almost time. You think it's almost time, but Jesus can hold anything back. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And no answer sometimes is your answer. That's why he says stand. If I don't answer, you stand. Stand. Don't move. Well, Lord, you didn't answer me. Then don't move then. That is your answer for right now. Until I utter something. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Well, that verse, what? That was 45? Read 6. 46 said what? And when men, and why call ye Lord, Lord? Now, if that ain't simple, gosh, what you calling me Lord if I won't do what I tell you? Oh, pastor, what you call me pastor for? You don't do what I tell you. Pastor mean I'm over you. Pastor mean you acknowledging I'm over you. Lord meaning you, oh, he's over you. But you don't do what he tell you to do. So how we going to deal with that? You acknowledge I'm powerful and I'm a ruler over you, but I don't do nothing you tell me to do. Verse 47 said what? Whoso, and here is my saying. Okay, that's all I want. Now, let's go to the scripture we read this morning. I knew, Lord, I was missing something. Ezekiel chapter 5. Ezekiel chapter 5. For all y'all that didn't make Sunday school. Amen. See, some of y'all don't even come to Sunday school. I don't know why y'all got a problem with Sunday school. Let me explain the three services we have. Sunday school, Wednesday Bible class, and Sunday morning and Sunday night service. Oh, I guess that's what, four? Bible class is to gradually help you learn how to walk in the newness of life. Even if you don't have the Holy Ghost, it's designed to show you how to get through this complicated door. A more detailed way of getting through this complicated door. Sunday school is designed to help you to get to know your Bible, like the books of the Bible. You know, that's why. Now, I don't quite go that route as the general class, but if you go to the young people class and the teenager, they help you in that area. But Sunday school is designed to help you to get to know the Bible, Ezekiel. You know, because when you come in the sanctuary and I say go to Ezekiel, you don't know where Ezekiel at. You fumbling. But see, in Sunday school, they'll wait till you find, they'll help you. Oh, you got to turn over here. Or they'll give you a song. We used to have a song. And or they teach you how to say all of the Bibles. See, they teach you that. So when somebody say Ezekiel, you know what book is after and what book had come before. Amen. Then you come to Sunday morning, which is right now. This is designed to provoke you to say, I want to change. This is designed to say, I got a problem. I need help. Help me to get out this rut I'm in. Because you telling me exactly who I am and you don't know me. Listen, what must I do to be saved? What must I do to join the church? What must I do to get better? Tell me. I need to know right now. Sunday night is designed as an evangelistic servant to get you motivated to continue in what you learned this morning. So when you leave here Sunday, you pepped up, primed up, pumped up that you going to do it because I got to do this because you done told me all day what I did wrong. You done told me how to get right. You done told me I might as well get excited about it. And I'm going to walk out of here pumped up. Amen. So that's what coming to church is all about. But if you miss one of them ingredients, if you miss one of the ingredients on Sunday, you don't get the full result. You don't get the full benefit of what Sunday services or Sunday, which is God day, that's designed to make you better. Let me go back to my three again. Did y'all make Sunday school today? So y'all in Sunday service. What y'all going to do about Sunday night? Let's see how that work out. Let's see how that work out. You see, some of y'all, so if some of y'all was in my three, y'all already know y'all on y'all way to hell, wouldn't you? See, they got a fighting chance still. See, y'all still got a fighting chance, ain't you? Because I know you loan people money, you don't want it back. I know you loan people money, you don't want it back. You know if I give you some money, you better not offer it back to me. See, I'm better. I'm better than him. I don't even want you to offer it. Now, she's pretty good at that, and he's pretty good at that. But remember, you don't want to be in my three. Y'all are nine. I'm a 9 1/4. Get my point? I'm always advancing a little bit back. You can say when you make it. That's my mentality. I got to think I'm better. Because if I don't, you ain't going to think I'm better than you. Remember, I ain't competing against you. I'm competing against myself. That's why I say I don't care how much good I do. I haven't done good enough. But see, some of y'all say, well, I take care of my family. I paid my tithe. I went to church. See, that's why you ain't going to make it. That's why, because you comfortable where you are. I haven't been comfortable in my salvation since I've been saved. Watch this. Somebody said, where you get that from? He said, work out your own. No, let me deal with it because I know it's going to be tripping me. But I'm going to learn or I'm going to bust my lip. One of the two. I get it. Listen, Paul said, work out your own salvation with what? When did he say get comfortable? Talking about a straight gate. But see, folk living good, they think they do. Paul said, you better work it out with fear. Oh, man, did I do something wrong? Did I say something wrong? Did I mistreat somebody today? You got to wake up every day at the end of every day wonder where you went wrong doing today. But see, some of y'all done breathe through. Oh, I went to church. I paid my tithe. I ain't did nothing wrong. And then you have the nerve to get on your knees and pray and say, Lord, if I've done something wrong. If you've done something wrong, where you get that from? Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Ezekiel chapter 5. Come on, let's read this quick because we read it this morning. But I want to get the verse. I want to get the verse 3. Everybody got it? Chapter 5, verse 1, read. He say, and thou, son of man, take thee a sharp knife, take thee a barber's razor, and cause it to pass over thine head and upon thy beard, and take 3 balances of weight and divide the hair. Listen, divide it into 3 equal portions. Read. He said, thou shalt burn with fire a third part in the midst of the city. Kill them group real quick. Let them know I'm killing a bunch of y'all real quick because y'all ain't going to do right. Come on. He said, when the days of the siege are fulfilled, and thou shalt take a third part and smite it with a knife, and a third part thou shalt scatter in the wind, and I will draw out a sword. I told y'all that this morning. Verse 3 said what? Thou shalt also take thereof a few. Wait a minute. A few. Now watch this. He told this man, shave all your hair off your head. Shave all your beard off. That's a lot of hair, ain't it? A lot of hair. Come on, y'all look at me. I want you to see the picture of this. That's a lot of hair. What Isaiah? He back there asleep. He got a lot of hair on his head, don't he? That's a lot of strings of hair he got. Now he got a beard. I don't see none of us that would have really fooled a beard, but that's a lot of hair. Now God said, out of all that hair, I want you to choose 3 strings. We got an average of, I think we put 51 people on our membership report. 51 people. He said, out of all of them people, I don't want but 1 out of every 3. That's dangerous. Watch it. He said, out of all that, I never told y'all the definition of few, did I? Let me give you that before I tell you what I'm about to tell you. Because I want some of y'all to walk out of here afraid today. Amen. God said, out of all of that hair, I want you to pull 3 strings out. Wait a minute. Let me say this before I give you the definition. That mean, watch this. That mean that man had to chew the 3 strings. See, few mean 3. That's 1 definition. Few mean 3. That means 1 out of every 3. Amen. He told that man, out of all that hair, you chew 3 strings and put them on your belt. In other words, you chew 3 strings and bring them close to me. You make that call. Told the man to do it. Ain't that what he told him? He said, thou shalt also take thereof a few in number and bind them in thy skirts. I'm going to tell you what that means in a second. But he said, you take them and bind them. Because see, their skirt, they had like a robe thing. He said, hang them 3 right there. Protect them for a few minutes. God said, the 3, what did he tell Peter? Whatsoever you bound on earth shall be. Whatsoever you loose on earth shall be. God said, I give people power to watch out. But to watch out for who they think. Now, what the word few mean? 1 definition means small, short. Watch this. Brief. I like that one the best. Brief. That means you can't even keep up with it. It's so short. How can you have all this hair and you chew 3? That means you got to take time. 1, 2, 3. You got to pull 3 out. And he said, take them and bind them. Put them on your way. Keep them close to you. Now remember, he's the Son of God. That's what he says. I mean, Son of Man. What did he call him? Son of Man, Son of God, or something? Amen. Son of Man. Remember, I've made you a watchman over everybody, and I'm going to tell you how to get rid of everybody. I'm going to tell you how you weed everybody out. Preach hard and let the fake ones run. Let them go. Burn them up. Preach hard. Get them out your way fast. Now, the other group that want to listen to you, he said, preach hard, and when they get tired, they're going to leave and go find another church. Preach hard. The third group, he said, I want you to throw them out and preach hard and chase them. You better do right. What you say, in other words, correct them every time they mess up. Keep that sword pointed in their back. In other words, convict them, reprove them, correct them, and instruct them to all godliness. Stay on them. Hallelujah. Let them know as soon as they mess up, they can die and go to hell. Make them afraid. Make them afraid that if they steal today, they can go to hell. Make them afraid. Listen, somebody say, that's hard. Listen, a sword chasing you, what you think that means? And the word of God is a sword, isn't it?
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. He said, chase them and let them know. Somebody say, yeah, every time I go to church, you got to beat me. I'm chasing you. Yes. But then three. Watch what he said do with them three. Come on, I love this. Listen, hallelujah. Watch this three. Y'all got it? Verse 4, he said what? And take them again. Wait a minute. After you've done all of that with the rest of them, pull up the three. Take them again and do what? Cast them in the midst and burn them in the fire, for thereof shall a fire. Y'all ready for this? God said, take them three and burn them up. Now remember, them three been hanging out with God. Them three been hanging out with the Son of Man. They've been hanging out with God. And they still know, and they know what to do. They know what's right. They know how to live holy. But God said, now, when I get through using them, burn them up. Burn them up. But watch this. Watch this. The one he threw in the wind, burn up and die, go to hell, right? The one he said, kill with the sword. Not go to hell, but they die and they go somewhere. They go to God, right? The one that he killed with the sword, they go somewhere, right? The one he's chasing and chasing with the sword, meaning at some point they are going to die, right? And then he took the three that he loved the most and he killed them too. What God is saying, all of y'all are going to die. I'm going to kill all of y'all, Israel. I'm going to kill all of the saints. But here's the best part. Which three hung in there with me? Which three? Watch this. Paul died, didn't he? Got his head chopped off. What did he do wrong? Didn't Peter die? Crucified him upside down. What did he do wrong? Stephen. They stoned Stephen after preaching his first sermon. Listen, oh, hallelujah. Listen, they killed Jesus. In other words, listen, we all are going to die. But here's the best part. Are you on his side? Are you one he can trust? Are you the one living holy? So guess this. Wait a minute. We all came out Church of Apostolicity, didn't we? Right. But which one of us is on his side? Is all three of us on his side? How many of y'all that God done put on the girdle? And put right here and holding you close, protecting you until he decide what he want to do with you. In other words, I value these three, but he told the Son of Man, you choose three and put them on your side. Listen, hallelujah. God chose all of us, y'all, and put us on his side. But now we got to make a decision. Are we going to stay on his side? See, the difference between hair, they couldn't move, but we got the ability to move. We all going through that straight and narrow path, but how many of us? Got another one for you. Go to Matthew chapter 20. This is a good one here. Hallelujah. Are y'all with me?
Hallelujah.
Listen, let me read some of my notes to you. We're talking about the source of sin and righteousness. I guess that'll be the title of the message since God ain't gave me nothing else. The source of sin and righteousness comes from the heart. So y'all write that down. Jeremiah and Anthony. Amen. The source of sin and righteousness comes from the heart. So I
we, Jesus, God, we watch everything everybody do. And you could judge and say she or he got a beam or a mote, but what you got in your eye? So God is saying, I'm not going to sit here and tell y'all everybody here doing great. Everybody here got something going on with them. But here's my problem. God said, why are you looking at them? Go look in the mirror. You can't fix nobody. Because if you could, you would fix yourself. You ain't even fixed yourself. So how you going to fix John Porter's? You see yourself every day. You only see me. Some of y'all only see me 2 times or 3 times a week. But you're going to fix me. You're going to not talk to me to get me right. You're going to tell me, Pastor, what you preach, that ain't right. Okay, tell me. Come on. What are you preaching to yourself? I like what my pastor said. He just say this all the time. That sister must have made him mad. He said, this sister keep coming to tell him how to preach. He said, finally one day, he said, Lord, can I say something again? He said, when God going to, he said, God's so busy telling you how I preach. When God going to tell you to put them cigarettes down? He said, no, you didn't know I know you smoke cigarette? He ate up. But he told that story all the time. Because the sister kept telling him what to preach. He said, when God going to tell you to put them cigarettes down? He's so busy talking to you and ain't told you one time to put them camels down. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, let's go to Matthew. When your heart is corrupt. When your heart is corrupt, what do you mean, preacher, when your heart ain't no good? What do you mean, preacher, when you only do what sinners do? When you only be good to those that be good to you? When you only love them that love you? When you only loan to them that you know gonna pay you back? So what you think kind of person is that? He say, sinners do that. Sinners do that. Dazon, sinners do that. Sinners do that. Sinners do that, son. I see that. Sinners do that. Yeah, what y'all do, sinners do that. Let me see you do something extra. See, that's why I tell y'all all the time, you got to impress me. Because everybody doing something in the church. Let me see you do something extra. Let me see you come up here on your Saturday and and use your whole Saturday to do something for your church. You just come here and all you want to do is sing in the choir. Sinners do that. But y'all think you're doing something. God said, y'all ain't doing nothing to impress me. God said, you got to impress me. But folks want to say we ain't got to do all of that. Well, I showed you today, if you doing what sinners do, sinners don't come to church and give God their money faithfully. Sinners won't come in here. I'm talking about if we are true saints. Sinners won't come in here. Let me use me so won't nobody get offended. Listen, ain't nobody going to put their money in the church like me and Sister Porter's done unless they love God. I know a lot of preachers and pastors. They will not lose their home to keep their church going. They say that ain't of God. But Jesus gave up everything. Peter gave up everything. Paul gave up everything. But Bishop, God don't want me to do that. Well, who are you marking? Because he said mark the perfect man. The perfect man did that. Oh, hallelujah. So you see what I'm saying? Let me see you sacrifice. Let me see you sacrifice. Come on. What did I tell you to go? Chapter 7. Go to verse 20. Hallelujah. You got it? Verse 19. What does this? Wait a minute. Let's go to verse 16. Since I'm getting ready to close. No, I don't want that part. Come on, verse 16, read, what does it say? Ye shall know them
Do men gather grapes of thorns or figs of tinsel? Listen, when you go out to get grapes, they don't want the thorns, they don't want the tinsel, they want the grapes. How many of y'all come to church to be deceived? I don't come to church to get some truth. Whether I do it or not, Pastor, is irrelevant. But tell me the truth. I don't come to church to be lied to. I can do that to myself. I don't need nobody to lie to me. Amen. Come on. Verse 17 say what? Even so, every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree. Now, how do you bring forth corrupt fruit? Out of your heart. Remember, out of the abundance of the heart. That's why I tell y'all that all the time. Watch what you say and what you talk about. Because out of the abundance. Now, see, what you really got to get with that statement. Jesus say you only talk about what you are full of. That's all you, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaking. Whatever you like, love, want to do, that's what you're going to talk about all the time. Amen. Come on. Read. What verse? 18. A good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit, neither can a corrupt tree. Okay, back over here where my two at. Read that verse again. So, would y'all give somebody y'all last $150 if they ask for it? Because I would. Now, if you can't do that, because the Bible said, give to him that's asking, turn not thou away. And him that would borrow of thee, don't ask for it back. That's scripture. I can show y'all that. That's in the Bible. So now, can we do that? Because I can do it. You see what I'm saying? But we both went through the straight gate, didn't we? We both got the Holy Ghost. I mean, all three of us. We both are baptized in Jesus' name. We both go to church. We both read our Bible. We both go to Enum. We both, I mean, we all three of us, brother. All three of us study. All three of us do the same thing. But who's really doing the best at it? That's where the problem comes in. See, you're going to be in a group of three. That's a given. But who's the best out of them three? God said, I'm only going to choose one out of that three now. See, here's the funny part. Y'all don't know who your other two are. He gave one man 5 talents. He gave one man 3 talents. He gave one man 1 talent. But the Bible lets you know they didn't even know who the other one was. Isn't that something? So the one that had the 5, he did what he was supposed to do. The one that had the 3 did what he was supposed to do. But that one that had the 1, he must have been in my group. That's why he didn't make it. In other words, they all three of them had 3 different groups. He said, but 2 of them made it in their group, but the other one didn't. What's the point here? All three of them was used by God. That's the story, y'all. But one of them just did not. And then he had the nerve. Ooh, glory, hallelujah. That's not in my note. He had the nerve to go to the Lord and say, I know you're a hard man. And I know you like to reap where you don't work at. I know you like to get and don't do nothing. So I hid. In other words, I know God is hard. I know God worked hard. I know God wants your money. Listen, y'all know what God wants, and you still won't do it. You know you in a straight gate. You know you in a complicated position. You know you can miss heaven at the pop of a finger, but you still won't do right. What did Jesus say to the man? He said, if you knew I was hard, then why did you go and leave, put my money and make some interest? What did he call him? A lazy. You're lazy. Didn't I tell y'all this morning? Your first problem is you outside of beach, you're lazy. You're just lazy. You won't do nothing. Yes, strive. We're going to read that before we close. Come on. Come on, chapter, I'm back in chapter 7, verse 19 said what? Every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewed down. Verse 20 says what? By the fruit, by the fruit, by the fruit. Come on, read. 21 said what? Not everyone.
Listen, listen. God said, everybody that's calling me Lord ain't coming in. He's telling you that right there. Everybody ain't coming in. 22 says what? Many, 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 many. Many, 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 many. Read. Wait a minute. I'm back in my two again. Didn't we all preach in his name? You're a preacher. I'm a preacher. You're a preacher. We all prophesied in his name. Come on. What else? And then, wait a minute. Ain't you done prayed for folks and they got better? Me too. You done prayed for folks and they got better? Okay. Come on. What's the next one? Wait a minute. Ain't you done a lot of wonderful things? Yeah, you done helped folks in the VA. Still helping folks in the VA. I done helped a lot of folks get saved. Look at all these people. They all here because they want to hear something I got to say. I done helped them somewhere. If it ain't but one time or a teensy-weensy time, listen, ain't you done help people? Because you go out and help folks. You go visit folks. You on the calling list. You what you call hospitality. You go to the council. You hospitality. You spend your money. You done a whole lot. But wait a minute. We all done a whole lot. Many. Now, we ain't included y'all. We just talking about the three of us, what we've done. Many will come. Come on, read. Many will come. Start from the top. Take the verse from the top. What does it say? Come on. We've done a lot of wonderful work. What else? Then what I say with an attitude. Profess meaning I'm saying it because I don't. What you doing in my house? I don't know you. Read. I will profess unto them. No. He said, I don't know you. I never knew you. Do God know y'all? Because I know he know me. Like I say, you don't want to be in my three. Listen, but we all done something. What are you saying? Everybody that was doing something must have went through that door and did something right. But they didn't continue or didn't do everything or didn't do all. Something went wrong somewhere when they went through that door. Or maybe they only got a foot in the door. I don't know. I'm just trying to get you to see. You better make sure what you're doing is right and you don't ever slack up. He said, because where much is known, that means whatever you're doing, you better get better at it. Whatever you think you know what to do, you better get better at it. Come on, read. Verse 23 says what? I will profess unto them. I never, never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. Go back to Luke chapter 13. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 13. He said, I never knew you. Some of y'all walking around here got the Holy Ghost. Some of y'all walking around here faking like you got the Holy Ghost. Some of y'all walk around here and think you don't have to get the Holy Ghost. You don't think you have to be baptized. It ain't a big deal. All right, y'all keep playing. Keep playing. God gonna make sure he put you with me. Because he know if I hooked you up with John, it's an easy call. Somebody say, you make it sound like you got it. Nope. But I don't work like I don't have it either. I don't live like I ain't gonna make it. I live like I'm going to make it. Because out of the abundance of the... Watch this. As a man thinketh in his... So is he. So I think I'm going to make it. Now, if I think I'm going to make it, I'm going to act like I'm going to make it. I'm going to say I'm going to make it. So therefore, out of the abundance of the heart, I'm going what? Because I'm going to do what it takes to make it. Because I know to make it, I got to have good fruit. I can't lie to myself and say I'm going to be raggedy and think I'm going to make it. I know that's a lie. Because I look at myself in the mirror and go, no, John, you can't. John, you can't. John, you can't. John, you can't. And I got to keep telling myself. So since I think I'm going to make it, out of the abundance of my heart, I'm going to say it. Because when I, oh, hallelujah. Because I know I got to be right. I got to live holy. I got to be nice. I got to give. I can't live like the average saint. And I so can't live like a sinner. So that means I got to work hard. Well, read. What did he say? Strive. Come on, you got it? Verse 13, chapter 13, verse 22, 24. What does he say? Strive. Do what? Strive. Do what? Strive. Do what? Strive. You got to bust your back. You got to bow your back and take it. Don't y'all know what strive mean? Do I really have to give you the definition of strive? That means you got to work hard. Man, every time I see this brother coming, he want my money. I'm going to give it to him, Lord. So, I need to buy $5. Okay. I'll tell you what, take it all. This brother came to the door the other night. The brother came to the door the other night. Beat on my window. Church. I'm saying, hey, I'm thinking it's one of the saints. That's what I thought. So I unlocked the door. So I went in the door unlocked. He's standing there. Hey, Reverend, remember me? Yes, I remember you. Because every time I see you, you begging. So begging you. Two go together. And I'm going, Lord, he's going to ask me for some money. And then he's driving a better car than me. He said, well, you know, I got a car. And I'm looking at him and saying, man, I'm going to say, man, you're driving a better car than me. And you begging me, but I'm saved. I'm striving to keep my mouth closed because I want to say something. Oh, y'all don't do that. Y'all just give in real easy. So I know y'all don't have those problems. I have those problems. But I'm striving. Lord, help me to keep my mouth closed because I want to say something, but I ain't going to say nothing, but I want to say something. Help me to shut up, Lord. Hallelujah. I'm striving because I got to be able to give to him that asking. I know the scripture. I'm quoting the scripture while I'm striving. Jesus. And I said, you know what? I said, you know, I'm going to say it in the lie. I ain't got no money. Or did I say it? I can't remember. Now, I may have said it. But anyway, I said, you know what? Here, I tell you, take it all. Take it all. Just take it all. Oh, thank you. I said, no problem, man. Anything else? No, I'm gone. I'll see him again in 6 or 9 months. Because that's all he does. But it ain't about him. It's about that word right there. What's that word? Come on, everybody say that word. Because the script. God says, somebody don't believe y'all got to give it all the time. Come on. Let me show you that. Let me, come on, let's go to Matthew. Chapters, what is it, 7? Somebody help me out. Give to him that asking him that would borrow of thee. Say, ye have heard that thou have said. Maybe chapter 6. Come on, we're going to find it. Y'all going to read it. 542? No, that's, yeah, 542. That's it. Matthew 5:42. 5:42. Everybody read that. See, don't listen. I told y'all, don't doubt me when I tell you it's in the Bible. I strive. I'm full of it. I'm full of it. Because that's all I do. I'm full of it. Because I'm going to heaven. Listen, I'm going to heaven, y'all. And I really want to take everybody in here with me. I really do. But I'm going to save myself first. Yes. Come on, verse 42. What does it say? Wait a minute. Do what? One more time. Give to him. Keep reading. And him that would. Him that would. Him that would. Read. Turn thou not. And then I had some so-called saint gonna tell me what the Bible said, what you supposed to give to me. I said, you're right. I gave it to him. Right? And I said, now can I borrow it? Now I gave them 20. I said, can I borrow 30? I want my 20 back. And 10 of yours. No, the Bible said, if I ask, you're supposed to give it. So, and guess what? You just quoted that scripture. You thought that was just for you, huh? You thought that was your. And then I told him, I don't want your money. I said, but I got another scripture for you. There's another scripture that said that at some point you ought to be able to work and give to somebody else. So when you going to stop begging? Wait a minute. I got another one for you. Y'all want me to keep going? Another one said, oh, no, man, nothing. You owe me. Wait a minute. You owe me. I ain't supposed to ask for it back.
But you ain't supposed to owe me either. Are y'all with me? So you see how you got to strive? So the best way to stay out of trouble, don't borrow no money from nobody. Don't ask nobody for no money. Work with your own hands. Amen. And what I need food to eat. If a man don't work, you want to eat? Go get you a job. Come on, amen. Let's give the Lord a hand praise. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody want prayer. Come on, ministers. Come on, Aaron and Cassini. Y'all come up here. Come on. Somebody want prayer. I know somebody want prayer. I know I would want prayer. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. What am I saying? Listen, y'all. Listen. You're going to be known by your fruit. Whatever is in you, going to come out. The Bible said your sin will manifest itself. It's coming out. It's just a matter of time. It's coming out. So it's better for you to just get it out today, confess it out, repent it out, get it off the chest, go on down the road and say, Lord, don't let me mess up tomorrow. Help me to look good every day of my life. Help me to stop sinning. Help me to just be honest and upright. Help me, Lord. I need help because this, listen, what I'm doing is wrong. The way I think is wrong. How I respond is wrong. My slothfulness is wrong. I don't want to continue to be wrong. I want to get this thing right. And we can't do it without Jesus, y'all. I don't care how much Holy Ghost I got. I can't do it without Jesus. And I ain't letting him go. I got him locked around my arm. Yeah, let me have some hot tea. I got it locked around. I got him locked around my arm. I got my arm wrapped around him. Because I can't afford. I can't afford to mess up. I can't afford to mess up. Because I can be in some three mixed up with two folk and be the worst one too. I'm believing I'm going to be the best in my group. I'm believing I'm going to be the best in my group, Tommy. I'm going to be the best in my group. Because you might outdo me and I don't make it. Listen, we really got to work hard at this. He said, strive, strive, strive. That means work hard at this. But folks want to say you don't have to work hard. Where you get that from? You got to strive to enter in. You see the door. The door is open. It's visible. But you look and say, I ain't going in there. That's too much trouble. I ain't going in there. But yet you know it's the right door. You know it's the right door. Now you got to work up. How you say? We say we got to muster up some energy. Okay, Lord, I'm going to go. Okay, Lord, I'm going to do right. Okay, Lord, I'm going to make sure I go to Bible class. I'm going to make sure I give my tithes and offering. I'm going to make sure I go to Sunday school. I'm going to make sure I know I'm used to watching ball games. I know I'm used to relaxing on Wednesday. I know, but I got to change. Lord, you got to help me. See, and that's the key to it all. When you make up your mind you really want to do it, then you say, Jesus, you got to help me because I really want to do it. Like Paul said, but I find in me when I want to do good, evil always shows up. Oh, but I want to do this thing, man. I really do, Lord, but I need you. I need you. Come on, Sister Beverly. I need you.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus, at the mention of your name, every knee shall bow and tongue proclaim, Jesus.
Anybody want to be baptized today? Today's a good day to get baptized. Let me tell you what baptism does. It removes all of your sin. If you got any sins on you, God will, when you come up out of that water, God don't remember none of your sins no more. That means everything you've done up to this point, God said, I don't remember that no more. Now, you may remember, and your family, but God say, he doesn't remember. And that's all that matters. We got all of the clothes you need for males and females. You don't have to schedule a date. We can do it right now. We got a pool of water. We got clean, fresh, white clothes. Amen. Hallelujah. We can protect your hair and everything, lady. All you got to say, I want to be baptized. All you, hallelujah. All you got to say, I want to be baptized. I don't want to walk out here today in my sin. I want them gone.
I want them gone. Every knee will bow and tongue proclaim Jesus. Well,
then you're going to get baptized then. Papa David, get the water and stuff ready.
We are Savior, you are Lord, and you
come on,
are
we got one young person say he wanna be baptized. I thought he was baptized already. Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Getting baptized, that's wonderful. Hallelujah.
At the mention of
well, Joseph,
your name,
Joseph, go help him. Help him get ready for baptism. Find out what you need to do. Follow Papa David.
Jesus,
follow Papa David.
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Anybody else want to be baptized? Come on, y'all know y'all got sin. Y'all got to get off you. You need to get these sins off your back. You need to get rid of them.
Jesus.
Get the devil out your courthouse. Get the devil out of your mind. Get the devil out of your spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
At the mention of your name, every knee will bow and tongue proclaim Jesus. Jesus. You are Savior, you are Lord, and you are God.
Jesus, Jesus, hallelujah.
Jesus, Jesus, at the mention of your name, every knee shall bow and tongue proclaim. Jesus, Jesus, you are Savior, you are Lord, and you are God. Jesus.
Isn't Jesus wonderful?
Jesus.
If you know Jesus wonderful, wave your left hand.
Of your name.
Isn't he wonderful?
Every knee shall bow and tongue proclaim Jesus.
Jesus is wonderful, man. He's wonderful.
Jesus, you are Savior, you are Lord, and you are God.
Come on, nobody else wants to be baptized. A good day. It's a good day. I get to do the baptismal today. Amen. Y'all should want the pastor to baptize you. Amen.
Thank you,
Jesus. Want to get baptized?
And tongue proclaim.
It's a good day to get baptized. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Jesus, you are Savior, you are Lord.
All your sins can be gone today.
God.
Every sin you committed could be gone today. Every lie you told, God will throw it away today.
Jesus.
Amen. Every joint you smoke, every bit you drink,
of your name.
Hallelujah. Everything you've done, God said, I will take it from you today and I won't remember it no more. I remove every evil thought you've had and never remember it.
You are Savior, you are Lord, and
y'all gonna pass that up? I wouldn't pass that up.
Jesus, Jesus, at the mention of your name, every knee shall bow and tongue proclaim Jesus, Jesus, you are Savior, you are Lord, and you are God.
Come on, shout hallelujah. Come on, shout. Anybody else want prayer? Maybe you don't want to get baptized. Maybe you want prayer.
You want prayer? Maybe you want the Holy Ghost. Amen. Today is a good day to get the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Maybe you just want a refreshing. Maybe you're saying, Lord, I just need you to touch me again today. I just need you to reaffirm, comfort me, help me. Hallelujah. And maybe you just need God to just do something for you internal. Maybe something just ain't clicking right. And you're like, Lord, I need help. I need help. I need help. Come on, if you just need God to touch you again today, stand to your feet. If you just want God to just touch you again today, stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you just feel like I just need something else, Lord. So maybe I'm not even quite sure, but I know I don't like where I am. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Maybe you just don't like where you are today. Even after you done got prayer, it's like, Lord, something ain't right. Something just ain't clicking right. I'm not sure what it is, but I don't want to walk out of here the way I came in here. So I need you to do just a little something extra for me. Amen. So maybe I just need to speak in tongues again. I ain't spoken in tongues in a long time. Maybe I just need to speak in tongues again. Maybe I just need, the Bible call it a refreshing. Maybe I just need a refreshing. Hallelujah. Maybe I just need a refreshing. Thank you, Jesus. Because God is good. But you have to want him. You got to come to him. You got to ask him. Everything is laid on the table. But he said, that's as far as I'm going with it. It's on the table. I like to tell people, when you come to my house, the first time I cater to you. After that, you on your own when you come to my house. I ain't going nothing. I let you. I trust you. That's why I let you in here. Amen. I ain't hiding no beer. I ain't hiding no whiskey. I ain't got no dope hid. So you ain't going to run up on nothing but good stuff. Amen. So God say, I done touched y'all. I done filled you with the Spirit. All I need you to do now is just come to the table. It's on the table. We call the altar the table. It's on the table. Amen. Hallelujah. So everybody that want another touch from God, come on and let me anoint you. Then I'm going to pray for everybody. Amen. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I know what it's like sometimes to feel like it just it ain't good enough. I'm missing something. I'm missing something, Lord. I'm missing something. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You don't have to come if you don't want to now. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name. Wonderful Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Say, Lord, I just want to speak in tongues again. I just need a refreshing. Hallelujah. I just need a refreshing, Lord. I just need a refreshing in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of, say, I'm tired of not having the zeal that I once had in the name of Jesus. I'm tired of not having the zeal in the name of Jesus that I once had, Lord. I'm tired of not having it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, shout hallelujah. Come on, y'all praise him while you go back to your seat. Just give him some praise. Give him some praise. Give him some praise in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, just praise him. Talk to him. Talk to him. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Just talk to him. Talk to him. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, talk to him. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty, wonderful name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, I don't hear y'all praying. Praying, praying, praying. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name, Jesus. Jesus is your healer. Jesus is your comforter in the name of Jesus. Jesus is your helper in the name of Jesus. Jesus is your strength. Hallelujah. Jesus is your doctor in the name of Jesus. Jesus is your comforter in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus is the wonderful God, the mighty God, the Prince of Peace in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. Come on, shout hallelujah in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, come on. Come on, hallelujah. Come on, stand on your feet. Come on. Y'all want it from God, don't you? Y'all want to get something from him today, don't you? Hallelujah. Did I get you? In the name of Jesus. Y'all want to get something from him, don't you? In the name of Jesus. Come on, if you want it, you got to call on him. If you want it, you got to call on him. Hallelujah. If you want it, you got to call on him. You got to praise him. Hallelujah. All you got to do is praise him. Come on, lift up some praise to him. He said he dwells in the midst of praise. You want him to come in and touch you right now? He said he dwells in the midst of praise. He dwells in the midst of praise. But you got to praise him. Hallelujah. He dwells in the midst of praise. He dwells in the midst of praise. He dwells in the midst of praise. He dwells. Hallelujah. I feel him coming strong for you. I feel him coming towards you. I feel him. Y'all bringing him in. You ushering in his presence. That's what you got to do. Just usher in his presence. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Father God, hallelujah. These are your people. These are your creation. These are the folk that you've called this day. These are the ones that you touched this day. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, they want a refreshing. They want some encouragement. They want a renewing. They want to be strengthened. They want to be, they want to be touched by you today. They want to be stirred up by your spirit today. They want to be, hallelujah, Father, hallelujah, touch their heart. Touch their heart right now. Touch their mind right now. Touch their inner soul right now. Touch them like you never touched them before, Lord God. Hallelujah. Let them know that you're still there. You've not left them. You're still with them. Hallelujah. Let them know, hallelujah, all you want is a pure heart and an open mind. All you want is a pure heart and a giving spirit. All you want is a pure heart and a contrite spirit. All you want, hallelujah, let them know, Lord, hallelujah, that you're here for them. Let them know you're here for the refreshing right now. You may only rush anymore. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. But you got to praise him. When praises go up, blessings come down. When praises go up, blessings come down. He said, I dwell in the midst of praise. Hallelujah. I dwell in the midst of praise. If you praise me, I'm right in your face. If you praise me, I'm right in your presence. If you praise me, I'm right in your mind. If you praise me, but you gotta praise me. You gotta praise me. Hallelujah. 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 God want to rekindle the fire some of y'all done let go out. God want to stir up the flame that y'all done let die down. God want to blaze you back up, the one that have gotten weak. God want to pick you back up if you start to get tired. God want to stir you back up if you're tired of being moved. God say he want to do it. 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 He want to make us better, y'all. He wants to make us better. 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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So, Lord, come on, everybody. So, Lord, I give myself away. Lord, I give myself away. Lord, I give myself away. Hallelujah. Because I want to do better, Lord. I know I come up short sometimes. I know that. But I'm tired of coming up short. I'm tired. I want to do right all the time. I want to do right all the time. I want to be able to do the things I know I'm supposed to do all the time. All right. Is the individual ready? Is Aaron ready? Beverly, you can close. But before he closes, I want all y'all to turn around. You don't leave your seat, so you can see now. And watch this soul go down.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus. Let's give the Lord a hand praise for that wonderful word. And for the soul that's about to be baptized today. Amen. Heaven is rejoicing. Thank you, Lord. That's right. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Heaven is rejoicing. Come on. Hallelujah. 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 The few, the proud, the church of apostolicity. Amen. Amen. The few, the proud, the church of apostolicity. Amen. For me, y'all know I was a Marine. Amen. Not was, I am a Marine. Amen. And we hold that title seriously. Being a saint, being a saint in this church, we should hold that title seriously. Amen. I was just thinking about boot camp because being in the military, you learn a lot about God and just how he functions. And I was thinking about the branch that I chose to go into. A lot of people say, I ain't going into that branch. Y'all look sharp. Y'all real strong. Y'all brave, but I ain't willing to go through that. I'm not willing to go through that. Amen. Looking at this church, amen, a lot of us give up our lives. And even though it may seem like we giving it up, God does so much for us. so much for us. And I was thinking about the end of boot camp. It's called a crucible. They stand back, your drill instructors looked at all your aptitude, everything that they taught you. And at the end, you're evaluated. The crucible is to see where your heart is. Are you worthy of a title of a Marine? God, I look at what happened today with all the saints in this remnant church. God is trying us. Can we stay the crucible? Yeah. And look at what happened today. Let me read something real fast where I found which was interesting on the definition of what crucible means. A situation of severe trial or in which different elements interact, leading to the creation of something new. We got a soul today because we went through a crucible, because we're apostolic. This is our church. We're going to stand the test. We're going to go through the trials. We're going to remain saints for God to get the glory. And then every time we do that, something new happens. All heads bowed. In the precious holy name of Jesus, Lord God, we say thank you. Thank you, Lord God, for just putting us to the fire, Lord God. The couple strands, Lord God, that we are, Lord God. Hold us to your hip, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. Keep us close to you, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. And those of us, Lord God, that you threw into the wind, keep chasing us, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. But we prefer to be by your side, Lord God. We prefer, Lord God, to be on the Lord's side, Lord God. So continue, Lord God, to dig around us, Lord God. Burn us up that we may be an example, Lord God. Hallelujah. We want to be worthy, Lord God. Whatever you do with this life, Lord God, because you gave it to us and you can take it away, Lord God. So we say thank you. Thank you for your saints, Lord God, that stand the test, Lord God, that can take it in the chest, Lord God, when we get reproved, because we know we fall short. We know we're full of sin, Lord God. We know we're not worthy. Hallelujah. Because you're mindful of your people, Lord God. Hallelujah. And you never put anything on us that we cannot bear. Oh, hallelujah. So thank you, Lord God. Thank you for your minister, our pastor, Lord God. Continue to encourage him, Lord God. Continue, Lord God, to use him, Lord God, for the furtherance of your kingdom, Lord God. And there's so many lost out there, Lord God, that need to be saved, Lord God. Let us get to work, Lord God, that, oh, hallelujah, that you may be glorified. We want to say thank you for the soul today, Lord God. Thank you for something new, Lord God, in the midst of the crucible. Thank you, Lord God, for being mindful of us, Lord God, in our indecent ways and our sin, Lord God, that you give us a gift. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, that you're mindful for us to be able to see the presence of you working, hallelujah, in spite of an evil way. We say thank you. Bless you for our visitors, Lord God. Encourage them, Lord God. Oh, let them maintain what they heard today, Lord God. And let them know that this is a beautiful church, the best ministry, Lord God, the best word, the best church on this earth, Lord God. Hallelujah. There's no other greater God than you, Lord God. And they found them today. We say thank you. Thank you, Lord God, and continue to keep us until our next service, Lord God. We ask these blessings in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.